right back. Let's see, next up, bales. Or just bay to sort. So you have got even less levels on and only one win. But your ability seems like one of the one-hit KO ones, so you're probably very strong. Go ahead and do an endless run on a new stage, the Fantasy Island. So, let's see, we have Harbinger of Chaos. Increases crit chance. On crits, chance to gain special meter. Neat. So we want to do a crit focus build. Got it. I mean, that's very in character for So we're gonna want to do as many small hits as possible. That way we have as many chances for crits as possible. Take that as our defense and scaling. I forgot what button my dash is. Okay, it's control. I repeat, we have everything under control. Yeah, we'll go with that as our super. So we want this, and we want the glow stick, and the other thing. Sir, this is just a strong item. That's going to be our level up thing. It's not EXP, but sometimes it can be better. And you only need one, and suddenly you're getting double the benefit, which is really damn good. There's no real way of getting double EXP, so that's kind of it. Bomb and ball have a synergy? I don't think so. I'm going to use Bale's song as part of my D&D campaign, because play dice was important at the time. What does this actually do? I picked this up and have no idea what it actually does. Crit and haste, yes, that's something we want. Okay, good. So we have our survivability unlock, we have our we have our EXP unlock, we have our destroy everything unlock. Heh. Dicey. could get the sackle and mix that together, but I do not like that. Instant win button. Yes, that does seem fairly very broken. There we go. Now we have weapons we can focus on, and if others show up, then hooray. See, that does absolutely nothing for us, which is the one downside of this as an EXP item. Holy, we're already off the races, okay. Finally, we got something. Not what I'm going to be keeping, but at least it's going to do for now and keeping the bad guys off my back. So now there's a 1% chance for these guys to drop stamps as opposed to whatever it was before. We have enough offense, we don't need to worry as much about defense. Not approve of you slowing me, man. You've thrown off my groove, and for that you shall die. Haste at speed. No. I'm gonna make it so I can use my instant nuke more. Thank you. much prefer this version of the Devil Hat as opposed to what it was before, where it was like, oh hey, attacks close to you, attacks you do against close enemies deal more, and attacks against far away enemies deal more. Because that was just like, kind of ridiculous. Attack speed up, that's a good one. We are gonna be looking for that, and crit. And so that. I thought I was dodging that. Ham and bacon sandwiches. All of you shall die now. Ah. So it seems this was not nerfed enough. Yeah, the 1 second of invulnerability is really generous on that. Now this may get very flashy. For that, I apologize. Nah, it's a bit late for that. Waiting for the projectile one to drop. Curse and cutting board. Yep, those work. Fine, I'll start leveling out the class skills. Because I can't get through those with just anvils. See, we have only gotten, what, like, two or three anvil drops in the entire 13 minutes, which is ridiculously low odds. Run is looking to be very profitable, my god. Well, that didn't take long. Oh, and it it super large. Ay, ay, ay. Alright, let's see just how terrible this is going to be. I'll let you guys know, flashing light warning now. 3, 2, 1. Oh, that actually didn't go as super insane as I thought it would. Oh, it actually comes out of the sip. Oh, is it whenever you're near this specific sip, it will suit you? Huh. Well, that makes it a lot less random and terrible than I thought it was. Yeah, it just detects, are you coming near the sip, and then it will suit you if yes. Neat. I'm Day, thank you forever. We're gonna need that for later. You guys don't know we need that for later, but trust me, we need that for later. Yeah, we can get that. funny, it actually has no effect on her. Yeah, normally it says, the wielder of the weapon will become upside down, and makes the weapon fire backwards. Instead, this has no effect on Bay. Because Bay is already an upside down brand. Cool little, I guess, Easter egg or... Bamboo for like tree stuff? Damn. See this go when it pulls the bottle. Obliterates as expected. And 20 minute mark. Hi! Oh, there we go. You were just upside down. So yes, as expected, we one-shot the boss easily. But we're on endless mode. Well, air quotes endless. It's not quite as crazy as you think. But it does give us an opportunity to earn more money. You'll find there's a reason why I took movement speed as my form of defense. More Marines fleet out there, see? Alright, alright. Oh, it used to be that the beam only fired in, like, the side directions. And now it actually follows your cursor. Neat. That's a nice change. How are we still getting these? The drop chance was supposed to be increased by, like, a billion. We were supposed to get them all, like, way earlier. Damn, our crit chance is nearly 100% at 92. Man, that's Bay for ya. Little Chaos Beam. And this does increase our crit up to 142%. And under the sake boost, it goes up to 97. You think I level up once in a goddamn blue moon. Jeez, us. I picked Kaela's fucking blacksmith classes. And yet I've been getting almost no goddamn anvils. Well, we don't need this anymore because our crit's already basically maxed. Cheeseburger you. Mind you, I don't have, like, any major damage increases. I just have crit. That's all. Hey, bull. I actually have the anti-synergy of the max HP down and the max HP equals damage. You generally shouldn't take those two together. But here I am having done it. Anyway, can you see now why I chose movement speed as my defense yet? Are you catching on? Yeah, so Bay's ability to make enemies not move while it was useless earlier is, yeah, it's resulting in this right now, where we are alive and not dead, which cannot be said for a lot of timer runs. But don't worry, it gets even more crazy. Just wait. I didn't get the stat boost that time because I didn't wait 30 seconds, but that's okay. This ability is still just strong enough to carry. Now imagine this with like Gura's ability that like does a bit of damage to the screen and makes her attack like a little faster. Nah, that would not fly for the spam tactics I'm doing. Oh wait, you guys can hear me, right? Yes, okay, I've been paranoid about that for the last while. Uh-oh. Yeah. Oof. We got a whole bunch of coins, though. So. Sir. I believe you can check. Oh, there's no leaderboard. Not right now, anyway. Oof. Maybe my internet went out. Eh, who knows. Alright, time for the Hollow House portion of things. That did not technically count as a win for Bay because we didn't, you know, go insane. But yeah, that I would say is pretty good for a focus build, as in not just AoE standstill, everything dies. Pretty damn good. What chaos happened here last time? Damn. I need onion and tomato. Let's see. Yum. I just plant 8 tomatoes? Maybe. I don't know. I've already forgotten what the heck I was doing there. go and see. What do we need? Dark wood. Pretty much as expected. Iron. Not as expected. Dark wood, bunch of iron, bunch of lead. Now I'm gonna try going for the dark wood. For that, we need some of these goddamn trees out of the way first. That way new ones can sew up. Meant new trees, damn you. Surprised I got anything out of that. Still, neat. Not really, but got to nonetheless. We've gotten none of the dark trees that we needed. Okay. How much do we need? Like two more trees worth. AKA 8, if you're actually like using numbers. There we go. Mythical axe. Or just myth axe. So that increased the precision to make it easier to hit the hard spots. And increased the power a substantial amount. I did equip it, right? Yes. 2 dark wood and a bunch of iron lead stuff. Like opal or something? Neat. I don't think that's diamond. That's diamond. Got one. Really just do not get a lot of iron, do we? We are flussing diamond, but oh, where we wanna be. Sorry for being silent, I just focus a lot on this. And it doesn't really help, but sometimes it does. Still getting used to those. Main thing is it just throws off my flow when I'm going from level 4 to level 7 or 6. Because again, I don't do these by sight really, I do them by feel. Why I'm so terribly off half the time. What the muffin is this cheeseburger asking me? Not sure if you guys can see that, but friend said he was on Discord too much and wanted me to take his Discord account, so now we're talking through Steam. Thank you. What if we just straight up skip that one and go straight to... Damn, really? We're just gonna do that to him. I just never got the goddamn iron! Or lead! We had like 50 billion of this junk. Sorry, myth pickaxe. Maybe later. Got extra gather. Alright, next time we're going to obliterate all of these goddamn trees. Oh no, we're doing that now. These are the diamond equivalents, and I'm not able to take them down. Not fully, anyway. Not bad. Again, pretty good. Goddamn iron still. Oh. What if I switch to a lower pickaxe? Will the lower tier stuff start popping back up? Is that how that fecking works? Because if so, I'll be ticked. Platinum equivalent, which goddamn, a hell of a lot less messy than platinum. And you, manageable. Thank you. You're kidding me. I'm gonna be able to get this before I get... Okay, let's go get all the adamantium then. And then we're gonna call it once we get that. There we go, 7 lead, hooray. Oh, there's that super rare bamboo that we end up finding earlier on the floor after beating up some random guy. Okay, 2 more, basically. Thank you. Prism HP, 500. I'm not sure what that even means. There we go. We have something. What does it do? I have no fucking idea, and I swear to God, if it breaks, I will cry. Alright, I need to stop before I get fucking sucked into this for a million years. God, that was an hour!